1 Thessalonians chapter 5, this thought of an eternal thanksgiving that ought to begin today. You ought to be the most grateful person in the world right now. And I don't care if there's no money in the bank account. I don't care if you didn't get to eat last night. I didn't care if you drove in on fumes on the gas tank. I don't care if the air conditioner at the house is broken. You lost your job. The doctor gave bad report. You can find all kinds of things to be upset about. But I'm telling you, God's worthy of praise right now. And you ought to start an attitude of thanksgiving now that just continues in to the eternity. Because when we stand before Him, that's what we read will be. But how about give it to Him now? How about by faith just start offering those sacrifices of praise now? Look at 1 Thessalonians 5. Look at verse 16. The Bible says, here's one of the shortest verses in the Bible. Anybody know the other shortest, the actual shortest verse? John 11:35, which are the two words? Jesus wept. This one is only two words, but the words are bigger. Therefore, it doesn't take the record as the shortest verse. But here it is. Rejoice evermore. So statement right there. Rejoice evermore. Well, why didn't he say anything else? Because there's nothing else to say. Just rejoice evermore. Well, you don't understand. What about the context? Yeah, the context is rejoice evermore. Yeah, but I had a bad week. Rejoice evermore. Now let's keep reading. Pray without ceasing. In everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. What's God's will for my life, preacher? Be thankful. Give God an eternal thanksgiving sacrifice that starts today. And you can, if we were to pass out an ink, pen, and paper, and we were to say, write down your biggest prayer request and biggest needs, we'd like, can you give me two pieces of paper? We naturally find the things we don't like. The things that we don't agree with, the things that rub us wrong, we can easily find things we don't like. How about we then say, all right, now sit there and write something about the church, your spouse, your life that you do like. God's been good. My salvation. I don't know. Isn't it funny how we naturally could find a list of complaints very so quickly? But when it comes time to offer a thanksgiving sacrifice to God, we're sitting there coming up with silly things because we don't have anything we're truly thankful for. Isn't it funny how our list of needs is very precise and our list of thanksgiving is very vague? God says He's worthy now and forever. He will get it forever, but He ought to be getting it now by willing sacrifices made by you and I, offering in a wicked, sin-cursed world just sacrifices of praise to God, day and night, nonstop, praising God.